Hi, we're now going to show you a film of the grand opening of this fish pass, the first one from Unlocking the Severn on the main River Severn. It was about a month ago now that the piles at the entrance right at the top of this fish pass were removed. And as you can see, in just one short month, the actual grass is starting to take and it's really now blending into the landscape. So it was a really exciting day a month ago with all our partners here, the Severn Rivers Trust, the Canal and River Trust, the Environment Agency and Natural England. And let's just enjoy the film of that magical day. From the Environment Agency, and we're here today for the opening of Bevere Fish Pass. I've been on this project for, well, 5-6 years, and it's just so exciting to see the water finally coming round in this common bypass that you see behind us, and bypassing Bevere Weir, which is to my right. This is going to be so easy now for fish to come up, salmon, but particularly the shad, which is what we're working on here, to move upstream and to go back to their historic spawning grounds.
Hi, I'm Jason Leach, Programme Director, Canal and River Trust, the Unlocking the Severn project. Today has been a momentous occasion. I mean, it's been a 5-6 year project with partners. Canal and River Trust has leads, we've worked with the Environment Agency, Natural England and Severn Rivers Trust, with amazing funding from Heritage Fund and Life from Europe. We've brought together all our expertise to get these fish passes in place.
So I'm Mike Winstanley, I'm the head of river restoration at the Severn Rivers Trust. Today we're here to see the unveiling, if you like, of the whole new bypass channel at Bevere Island. It's a culmination of such a lot of hard work with partners, and basically it's going to make such a difference for fish passes, for our salmon, for the different species of shad, and so many other species of fish and biodiversity. And certainly it's going to leave a lasting legacy for generations.